everyone, it's Lily, and today I have a video telling you guys about the Amoco Polymer Clay and Craft Oven. This video is going to be basically an informational video. It's going to be an instructional how-to, so I'm going to be showing you guys how to use it. And it's also going to be kind of like a review at the end. I am going to be talking about this oven mostly for polymer clay charms use. Okay, so here is the box that the oven came with. So it's by the brand Amoco. It's called the Polymer Clay and Craft Oven. I will show you guys each side of the box. And if you want to read any part of it, you can just pause the video and read whatever you want. And then here's more of the information on the other side. So now you may be wondering, where can I purchase this oven? My sister got me this oven for my birthday, and she purchased it from the Joann's Fabric and Craft Stores website. At the time when she bought it, it was $64.99, but it was 50% off on the website. At this moment, right now as I'm filming, I believe it's not 50% off anymore. So $64.99 is pretty expensive, but there are other places where you can get this oven. What came in the box was basically the oven itself and this instructional pamphlet. Please, if you get this oven, read this pamphlet because it has a lot of great information. And in this video, I will only be telling you some of the really important things, but there is a lot of really other important information that you need to read in the pamphlet yourself. Okay, so like I said before, what came in the box was just simply the oven and the instruction manual, but there are things that you're going to need to purchase in order to use this oven for polymer clay charms. And the first thing that you're going to absolutely need, and I really, really stress this is not an optional thing, you are going to need to purchase an oven thermometer. This is an oven thermometer. You can get this probably at most supermarkets, grocery stores. I got mine in particular at Walmart, and it was only like $5. You really, really need this because when you're preheating your oven, you wanna set this in the oven so that way it can tell you exactly what the temperature is. You wanna have an oven thermometer just to make sure that just because you're setting the temperature, it might not always be that temperature, you know what I mean? So this is really important. You can order these online. It's just called an oven thermometer. Mine's by the brand Accurite, and I got mine at Walmart. So on the box, you can see that there's like a little polymer clay cat figurine, which they call a whimsical cat, and there's also a polymer clay brooch. And what it's baking on is a little thing that they call in the manual, a Teflon mat. I purchased a glass, kind of Tupperware container, but I bought this glass Tupperware to bake my things in. I made sure that it was a very small size that it fit in my oven. And if you will be baking your charms in a glass dish, I recommend using parchment paper, which is what I have in here. But if you're using parchment paper, you need to make sure that it's cut down to size. You do not want your parchment paper, you know, so big that it's coming out of your like glass container and, you know, outside of the container, because that's dangerous. If your parchment paper is anywhere near these little kind of like these things down here, and there's one on top, which is what heats the oven, your parchment paper could catch on fire if it's close enough. But if it's small and contained in a little container like this, you're going to be fine. Parchment paper does not catch on fire. It can, it does, but parchment paper withstands temperatures around like 450 to 500 degrees. And most polymer clays, you only bake them for like the highest amount of temperature for 275. That's what I purchased for my polymer clay oven. You wanna purchase a oven thermometer. This is a must. Please, please get this. A silicone baking mat, like I mentioned before, or you can do what I did, get a glass baking kind of dish, oven safe, and then parchment paper, and then putting your charms on them. So, yeah. And this is also really helpful because it came with a little lid. And this is just really helpful because when I'm not going to bake my charms, I put my charms in there so that way dust doesn't collect over time. So, yes. This is what the outlet plug looks like. It's one of these kind of standard ones that I'm familiar with because I live in the United States. This is the kind of outlet you want to use your polymer clay oven with. I don't know any kind of technical terms, but I'm showing you guys just to make sure that you guys have the right kind of setup to even use this oven. For first-time users, like if you purchase this oven, here are a couple things that you need to know. So now it's time for the demonstration, and I'm going to show you guys how to use this oven. So the first thing you want to do is plug in your oven, kind of like a no-brainer. So I'm plugging it in. Now that it's plugged in, you want to place in your oven thermometer either in the center or somewhere in your oven. I usually put it in the corner over here, and then I will close it like so. The oven will not be on until you set the timer. So as you guys can see, this power light is not lit, so that means it's not on. So what you want to do is set your temperature first, and as you can see, this is the temperature knob. It has from going 150 to 300 degrees, and I have it kind of set right at like close to 250, but not really, for 275. Now you want to preheat this for about 20 minutes. So I'm going to pull the knob a little bit past 20 and then pull it back again right on 20. So now the power light is on. You can hear that ticking noise. That's the timer. And it's going to start preheating my oven. Now I'm just going to let my oven preheat for 20 minutes. And I will get back to you guys. It's been going for a couple of minutes now. And as you can see within the oven, there is the little bars at the top and the bottom are like a reddish orange color, and the oven thermometer is telling me that it's about 250 degrees right now inside the oven. My thermometer is still at 300. Oh, okay, so that's the noise it makes when it's done preheating, and you always, always, always need to preheat your oven for 20 minutes. No matter what craft you're doing, you have to preheat it for 20 minutes. So I'm just going to take this down to about 250, and I do this about every time that I bake my charms. So I took it down to 250. I'm going to set the timer again. You want to set the timer immediately after it's done preheating, or else a lot of the heat will escape. I'm putting it at that dot, which is around 17 minutes. I'm going to open my polymer clay oven carefully. Do not touch any of the parts inside because it's very hot. I'm going to put in my little glass tray right there and then close it back up. So now it's going to bake for around 18 minutes, and I like to keep an eye on the thermometer. And this is why it's a little tricky with this oven. You want to make sure that the thermometer is around close to the temperature that you want. I put it back down closer to 250 degrees, hoping that it will fall closer to 275 degrees, but you just really want to watch it. So yeah, I'm baking it, and then I will show you a little bit more. My oven has dinged or donged. I don't know. But you want to be safe and have a towel or an oven mitt or something in hand. Open your oven carefully and then carefully take out whatever baking thing that you baked your charms in, and then place it on a heat safe surface. So I laid another towel down. So, of course, when your charms have been baked, here's another tip for you guys. What I usually do with my charms after they've been baked is I will take like a towel, place it down somewhere, and then I would take them off carefully because the wires will be hot, and then I will place them down on the towel, if you can see what I'm doing, and then wrap them up in the towel. So that way they can cool down slowly. If your charms cool down too fast, they will crack. So that's why I like to wrap them up in a towel. So yeah, okay, so now your oven is very, very hot and so is your container. Let these cool down completely. Once you're done baking, you want to pull out the plug. Do not tug on the cord because that can be very dangerous. You want to physically grab the bigger part of the plug, not the cord, this part, and pull. You always, always, always want to unplug your oven when you're not using it. Okay, you guys can kind of see my reflection. My final kind of wrap up about this oven and my review, I would give it 4 stars out of 5. I think it's a good oven. It's basically just a glorified toaster oven. That's really all it is. It's a toaster oven that this company has made and labeled it specifically for polymer clay and other crafts. If you cannot get this oven or anything and you don't want to keep using the oven in your kitchen, your conventional oven, because, and in all honesty, it does use up quite a bit of electricity and things like that, you can just get a toaster oven. In my opinion, toaster ovens will probably do the same job if you follow the same kind of like precautions with the oven thermometer. The oven thermometer is your best friend when it comes to baking charms with, you know, toaster ovens and small ovens like this. If you have an oven thermometer, it's probably gonna prevent the majority of like those incidents where your charms overcook or burn and whatnot, because your thermometer is gonna make sure you're baking at the appropriate temperature. And the reason why I give it 4 stars out of 5 is because of the fact that it's not a very accurate temperature, you know, device. Even if I set it at 250 degrees, it's not gonna heat up to exactly 250 degrees every time. It's gonna go up to 300, come back down. Even during baking, if it even gets to 250, sometimes it'll go back up to 300 for a little bit and then come back down. So that's pretty much the reason why it doesn't get a perfect 5 out of 5. And also the fact that this little time knob is so kind of complicated. Like, I wish they would just... Why would they set it up like that? I don't know. Is it just me or is that? I don't know. It just kind of gets confusing. But then again, math is not my best subject. Yeah, but honestly, I would give it 4 out of 5 stars. It's great. It's really, really super convenient. I don't feel guilty anymore about baking only 4 charms. I used to try to stock up on all of my charms before baking in the conventional oven because I didn't want to waste electricity. Yeah, so if you guys are looking maybe for a Christmas gift or something like that, I do recommend this. And if not, a regular toaster oven that you can get at any kind of like kitchen store or grocery store or market will do just as fine. From what I've seen in like different stores like Bon-Ton and Target and stuff, toaster ovens are around $30 or so, $30 to $40. And they will probably do the same job that this oven is gonna do. So whether or not you buy this polymer clay oven or another toaster oven, I recommend that it's gonna do the job for you guys as long as you do some of the tips that I instructed. If you get this specific Amoco oven, please read the manual. That's very, very important. If you are younger, have supervision with an adult and just, you know, craft safe, okay? Be a safe crafter. So that's pretty much it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I know it's going to be super, super long, but it's jam-packed with information, I hope. And check down below for links for where you can get this oven and information on baking polymer clay. If you guys have trouble with that, that link will be down below. So yeah, I will talk to you guys soon. Bye. Oh, look, that's exciting because you guys can actually see me wave. Okay, bye.